Hey everyone, it's Shirt of ChromaGlitch, and today I'm going to show you how to complete each altar for Dynus. This video will be broken into sections for each altar and will show you where to find the needed items. I'll also put a spoiler alert because I will be showing what the rewards are for each altar. So, spoiler alert, and let's get started. The Forge altar requires 300 wood, 30 earth crystals, 30 water crystals, 30 fire crystals, and 10 sand dollars. These are relatively easy to collect around Sunhaven and inside the mines. I had a surplus of trees, so I just cut down a few and used the wood from those. Gathering the fire and water crystals took most of the time, as I had to make multiple trips into the mines until I had enough of the crystals. The reward for the altar is the Phantom Plate Legs. The Phantom Plate Legs gives the wearer an additional 18 to defense, 55 to health, 9% movement speed, 11% jump height, and a 33% chance that the air skip will be Casper free. The Phantom Plate Legs requires the wearer to reach level 12 in combat. The Fruit Altar requires 20 raspberries, 10 peaches, 20 oranges, 20 blueberries, 10 berries, and 20 apples. This altar being a forgeable altar is another easy one to complete, especially if you've been upgrading your skill tree. Having the Double Take and Horn of Plenty skills in the Exploration tree unlocked came in handy for things I didn't already have the full amount of. Horn of Plenty causes trees to drop triple fruit, Double Take increases the number of berries and mushrooms you pick up off the ground, you can collect apples around Sunhaven on the farm, peaches are in the forest near Nelvari and in the village, oranges and blueberries are also found in the forest leading up to Nelvari. There's also a small section in the West Forest if you move the Snakkoon from blocking the entrance that continuously spawns fruits and berries. Once completed, you will receive a butterfly ring as a reward. The butterfly ring summons a butterfly companion that will protect you from the first instance of damage every 30 seconds. The mining altar requires 999 stone, 50 coal, 100 copper ore, 10 sapphire, 10 ruby, 10 amethyst, 5 diamonds, and 5 havenite. All of these resources can be gathered after several days in the mines in Sunhaven. Completing this altar will provide you with the King's Mining Key, which can be used to access the Glorit mines in Withergate. The Mining Key also gives you access to the only in-world smithing tools to craft Glorite tools. To complete the gold altar, you will need 100,000 gold coins and 10 gold bars. The reward for this altar is the Phantom Cape. The Phantom Cape allows the air skip to be used an additional time while mid-air. It also provides a 10% jump height, as well as a 10% increase in gold orbs and tickets earned from all sources. This paired with Anne's Pearl Earring keepsake and multiple skills will make earning your gold back easy. Is one of the more challenging altars and will require a lot of patience to complete. The altar requires one of each of the following fish types: Dorado, Dororado, Crab, Sea Bass, Goldfish, Bone Mouth Bass, Chromafin, Golden Carp, Flamefish, Permaid, Crystal Tetra, and Skyray. Each fish comes with its own difficulty and it helps to have as many of the fishing skills as possible. I completed the altar with the following skills: Oversized Bobber, Twin Hooks, Firm Hand, Exotic Attraction, Stick the Landing, and eventually Fertile Waters. You can find Dorado, Crab, Sea Bass, Chromafin, Golden Carp, and Goldfish around the Sunhaven region. Flamefish, Crystal Tetra, and Skyray can be found around the Nelvari region. You'll find Dorado, Bone Mouth Bass, and Permaid around Withergate's region. Another challenging altar is the Ticket Altar. This altar requires 5,000 tickets, which can be daunting. This altar will require completing as many daily quests from the bulletin board in Withergate as possible. Also spending plenty of time farming and fishing and selling the crops and Withergate fish. Once you have enough tickets, you can receive the Cerberus Mount Whistle. which will summon Cerberus to you. The Keepsake Altar requires 4 keepsakes to complete. The Peacekeeping Keepsake can be found at the Merchants before entering Nalvari for 40 mana orbs. The Romance Keepsake can be found in Sunhaven at Cynthia's shop. The Adventurer and Riches Keepsake can either be obtained at the start of the game based on your answers, or they can be purchased in Sunhaven from the Weapon Merchant. Once completed, you will receive the Phantom Plate Helmet. The helmet grants the wearer an additional 78 health and 20 attack damage. The Cooking Altar will require a combination of gifted, purchased, or crafted food items. You will need a cheesecake. This can be purchased at the cafe in Sunhaven or crafted using cheese, milk, and sugar. Spicy ramen can also be crafted using noodles and peppers. This can also be purchased in the cafe in Sunhaven. Sesame rice balls are crafted with rice and seaweed. A slice of pizza can be purchased at the bakery or crafted using cheese, tomatoes, and flour. Cookies can be purchased at the bakery or crafted using sugar, flour, and eggs. Coffee can be purchased in the cafe in Sunhaven. Tomato soup can be crafted using tomatoes and corn. Shimmer root treats can be crafted using shimmer roots and cinnaberries. And an energy smoothie is crafted using water crystals, apples, and oranges. Once completed, you will receive the Phantom Plate Gloves as a reward. These gloves require you to be at level 12 in combat before they can be equipped. They add a plus 12 to defense, 31 to attack damage, and a bonus 2 points towards farming experience. The Farming Altar is another one of the more time-consuming altars, especially if you're just starting out. This altar requires 30 of each of the following crops: wheat, corn, potatoes, tomatoes, carrots, peppers, onions, green root, lettuce, and rice. All of the seeds can be purchased at the general store in Sunhaven. Green root seeds can be found by weeding overgrown grass, while pepper seeds are often dropped by the pepper-shaped enemies on the beach. Once you complete this altar, you will receive the Phantom Plate Armor. This armor adds 35 to defense and 75 to health. Once all 9 altars are completed, you can then confront Dynus, and rather than initiate combat, select Give an Offering. This will complete the quest line, and you will be rewarded heavily. There is also a bonus reward option that lets you pick between 4 unique items. And that's the video. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you found any information helpful, please leave a like and be sure to subscribe for more Sunhaven content.